A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 1st July, on the front page you have, after surprise Trump-Kim meeting, nuclear talks to resume. So both leaders, US President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un, they met along the Korean border, that is along at the demilitarized zone between North Korea and South Korea. And here they agreed to resume stalled nuclear talks. So this is a significant development here, that the talks which had failed, the second round of talks had failed between Trump and Kim at the summit in Hanoi, Vietnam. And now they have again met and spoke of continuing or resuming the nuclear talks. So it is in the context that there have been sanctions imposed against North Korea by United Nations as well as by United States and other countries. And North Korea threatens with development of nuclear weapons. So the talks were to the nuclear talks, as they're called, so that North Korea gives up its nuclear weapons and sanctions against it are revoked. But then who goes first is the problem. North Korea expected that both would go simultaneously, but US President Donald Trump insisted that first it should it should eliminate all nuclear weapons and then only sanctions would be revoked. So of course that is non-workable and the talks had collapsed. Then this is Nagaland to initiate its own version of NRC from July 10. So this is regarding Nagaland. So it has decided to start a variant of its National Register of Citizens, which Assam, the neighboring country, has been updating. So this will be collecting information as such in Nagaland, and this is for 60 days the collection of information would take place. So basically it's to identify illegal migrants. So this has been announced. Then below you have mob thrashes woman forest officer in Telangana. So this is Kagajnagar forest officer Cholia Anita and her staff. They were attacked with bamboo sticks by Zilla Parishad vice chairman and his supporters in Telangana. And this is Muslim youth lynched in West Bengal. So Muslim youth who was beaten up by a few of his acquaintances in Malda district in West Bengal died of his injuries. So this is another case of lynching. And here you have two doctors assaulted after patient dies in hospital. A little time ago we had seen how doctors were protesting against the security conditions and how when patient dies, the relatives thrash them. So now in this another incident, you can see in Delhi, the doctor suffered minor injuries and FIR has been registered. The kin alleges that patient died due to negligence of as such. On page 4, you have most see free legal aid as last ditch option report. So this is a report as such. Pan India research has been conducted by this National Law University, Delhi. So you can see a majority of the people who are entitled to free legal aid system see the service as an option only when they cannot afford a private lawyer. So people don't have faith over the services of free legal aid counselors, because there are variety of reasons being given. You can see the systemic problem being discussed here. So the reasons being given, one, no resource to engage a private lawyer is one of the reasons why legal aid is sought. Second is commitment of the legal aid as such. So that is legal aid counsel. Then here you can see this shows no opinion. This shows others. And purple color is quality of legal service by the legal aid counselors. So these are the reasons why beneficiaries opted for free legal aid, and this is the average amount spent by legal aid counselor on legal aid in private cases. So you can see average time spent per week is shown here. So legal aid cases, how much time is spent, and on private cases, how much. So this shows in legal aid cases, you can see in 58% of the cases, 1 to 10 hours are spent per week on the case. In 37% of the cases, 11 to 20 hours are spent on the case. And in nobody spends more 20 and above hours on legal aid cases, no lawyer. And this is, you can see, where no comments came. So is maximum up to 20 hours which are spent, while in private cases you can see majority of the cases, 58% of the cases have lawyer spending 20 to above hours and above hours on the case. Then on page 7 you have 9 dead, 564 hospitalized in this year's heat wave in Maharashtra, says Directorate of Health Services data. So Nagpur, Gadchiroli, Chandrapur, Wardha, Akola, Yavatmal are the worst affected districts in Maharashtra due to heat waves. So it's over the years also you can see the number of cases of heat waves and number of deaths. You can see how the number of cases are gradually increasing, though there was a dip in 2017. Then this on page 8 is the continuation of the first page news. DSP suspended for attack on forester. So the incident has evoked widespread condemnation and forest minister has promised stringent action. A woman officer, you can see a woman forest officer being attacked by a mob with sticks. She had a hand fracture. Then this is Rajnath checks out stealth frigate submarine. So this is Defense Minister Rajnath Singh, who was on his maiden visit to Eastern Naval Command and reviewed the operational readiness of the command and other aspects of maritime and coastal security. So he you can see the frontline stealth frigate which India has, INS Shivalik and INS Indian Naval Submarine Sindhu Kirti. Then below you have, once a symbol of might, Tipu's armory is in ruins. So this is regarding Tipu Sultan's armory. This was prominently in news in 2017 too. So the monument was a hindrance to Bengaluru-Mysuru railway track. So it was doubling up work for many years there. So because it had to be passing through that region. So that is why the government, it shifted the entire structure with using a unified jack system. So this was first time in the country that this system was used and the armory was transferred. So it is said now this monument, which has been translocated 2 years ago, has turned into a dumping yard and public toilet. On page 9 you have, after Bihar, Uttar Pradesh braces for AES season, that is acute encephalitis syndrome. So now the disease has claimed more than 154 lives in Bihar. And now in Uttar Pradesh, 2 cases have been registered. Then this is cooperative help takes tribal craft to Amazon's global market. So this is also a very important point in culture, that how tribal craft has reached the global marketplace through online platforms and how cooperatives play a role here. And this is Rhino Protection Force deployed in Kaziranga. So this is 82 member special protection force which has been trained to combat poachers and understand animal behavior. So it has now been deployed in Kaziranga to protect the rhinos as well as look after tigers. On the editorial page, the first editorial is among members. So this is regarding G20 summit. It says glaring bilateral and global issues were highlighted at the G20 summit. So there were a number of issues, unilateralism and terrorism. So such issues were highlighted at the, and the trade wars also going on. So even the concerns within the Gulf region. So all these were the issues highlighted at the G20 summit, which are discussed. Also, issue of pollution has been at the center stage. Then this is new framework. The SEBI guidelines for mutual funds will help restore investor confidence. So recently, SEBI gave new guidelines for mutual funds. So it is said these guidelines will now help investors build confidence again in mutual funds. So mutual funds were having these standstill agreements with various companies, which SEBI said is not correct. They are not banks. They are not giving loans. So this is important development. Then the lead article is a thumbs down to unilateralism. So the US is acting like, in defiance of the agreed rules to target India's WTO consistent policies. So this is the unilateral approach of USA, which has been criticized in this article, and how India's policies are WTO compliant. Still USA asks India to change the rules. Like, look, there are various issues, data localization issues and other concerns which USC has raised, non-tariff barriers, which it calls, as well as tariffs as such, which are imposed. Then the next is adding value to a third enemy. So this is regarding Finland. So it says Finland wants to strengthen the European Union's global leadership in climate change. So this is now regarding the presidency, the European Union. So the presidency of the Council of European Union begins on 1st July, and the country to which the presidency has gone is Finland. So climate action is one important aspect which is highlighted. Then on op-ed page you have this article, it's time to act, not to do more research. So it says the resources spent in drafting educational policies should instead be spent in implementing solutions. So again, a draft national education policy is being developed, and you know, the EQIP, Education Quality Upgradation and Inclusion Program, which has been announced. So it is in that context. On page 13, you have procedural concerns in focus as GST enters third year. So industry groups seek simplification of registration and return filing to build on the gains as such of GST, and the revenue trend in recent months show a turnaround. So this is the trend line. So it is gradually increasing. The GST revenue has seen a steady rise over the last 2 years. And this is money in Swiss banks. India ranked 74. So India has moved down one place to 74th rank in terms of money parked by its citizens and enterprises with Swiss banks as such. And the top position is of UK. India is 74th. Earlier it was 73rd. Then on international page, there is no important news. We saw the Trump-Kim news on the front page. And this is regarding Taliban attack in Afghanistan. Then on Mondays, you have business review coverage. So this is a coverage on diversified gains. So this is regarding debt, equity, hybrids. So assets under management means the mutual funds, Indian mutual funds industry. What is their preference? Where do they invest? So it's debt, then equity, then a hybrid. So you can see the equity schemes, how are they investing? And this is again, how much is the liquid fund and how much is credit risk fund, which is shown here for debt schemes as well as for equity schemes. And this is for deployment of funds by debt. So, by debt mutual funds and by equity mutual funds. So, how do they deploy their funds? So, here you can see in corporate debts or in commercial papers or in bank certificates. So, that is shown for both debt and mutual funds as well as equity mutual funds. Then below you have why nuclear when India has an ocean of energy. So though the highly harmful source, nuclear energy is regarded as savior on certain counts, the country has better options, it is said, under the sea. So ocean energy can be better utilized than looking at nuclear energy. And this is regarding GST's development in GST, from baby steps to giant strides, GST gains momentum. So it marks its second year today, that's completed 2 years. So then on the last page you have Europe sizzles sweats in record heat. So weakening of the high level jet stream is leading to summer temperatures to soar across the European region. So we have seen how France has recorded highest temperature. And you can see Europe is now swelling in record-breaking temperatures. And this is commercial whaling is back in Japan. So Japanese whaling ships have prepared, are to set into the sea with crews gathering now. So commercial whaling hunt, which was banned in Japan, now has been brought back after 30 years. But then it will be confined to Japan's exclusive economic zone only. So eating whale is considered in Japan to be an important part of culture. And then you have World Health Organization brings in norm on self-care interventions. So it is said world will face a shortage of nearly 13 million healthcare workers by 2035, and 400 million will lack access to essential health services globally. So they are lacking access. So that is why World Health Organization has now brought in norms for self-care interventions. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. You can download the PDF for current affairs, which will be uploaded in the later part of the day. And also we have a current affairs video course. So detailed video of current affairs is provided through this course. The details of this course are provided here on our website. You can see in current affairs section. So this is the detail of the course as such too, provided here. So these are the important headlines, and that is it. Thank you.